All right, folks, a new leaked tool before MPS 2020, September, part two of their release party. All right, they're going to be coming out with a upgraded new Super Sawzall. All right, now they're not technically calling this the Super Sawzall. All right, just some improvements to the existing Super Sawzall. All right, I guess maybe they weren't happy. Maybe there was some complaints, but Milwaukee does this sometimes where, you know, a tool goes out onto the field and they get a lot of feedback from, you know, customers. And this has been out, you know, the Super Sawzall has been out for probably 2 years now. So they probably gathered a lot of information, a lot of pros, a lot of cons, what could be improved and whatnot. So they decided to do some, you know, updating and some improvements. Now, this is called the Milwaukee FUEL SAWZALL reciprocating saw with one key. All right. The model number is 2822-22. All right. Now, it's going to have 3,000 strokes per minute. All right. So the new DeWalt, right, that I just did a video on, it wasn't just probably a good 6-7 weeks ago. That also had 3,000 SPM. I want to say that the Super Sawzall has more SPM than that. So this is, you know, maybe not taking the place. This might be like a Gen 2 of their regular Sawzall. All right. I'm going to have to look it up. And, you know what? I'm going to look it up. Well, let's go over it first. All right. So, but you do have one key. All right. You got a pivoting shoe. Okay. That maintains contact with material for cleaner cuts. Tool-free quick lock blade change allows for quick and easy blade changes. Variable speed trigger up to 3000 SPM for fast cuts. Coming with 2 5-amp-hour battery packs. Again, kind of makes me wonder, right? I don't think that this is in any way like the Super Sawzall. All right, so the Super Sawzall is something I think totally different, guys. If you want my honest opinion, again, this is kind of like leaked information. Now there might be a lot more information out there, to be honest with you. I don't know, but what I'm gathering from here, it just doesn't make sense that this is, you know, like a Gen 2 Super Sawzall. So, you know, it might be a Gen 2 brushless Sawzall. But I think it's a little bit smaller than the Super Sawzall. You know, it weighs, I believe, 6.8 pounds. All right. So I think that's a little bit less. Now, 8.4 with a battery, 6.8 pounds bare tool. All right. You do have a rafter hook, anti-corrosion blade clamp. All right. LED light, 1 1/4 stroke length. All right. And of course, like I said, the one key connectivity. Like I said, we'll take a look at some pictures here. It definitely doesn't look as big. So again, I don't think this has really anything to do with the Super Sawzall. I think it's just a new Sawzall, right? And obviously, if it was, they would have called it, you know, Gen 2 Super Sawzall. So I got a lot of information. A lot of people were hitting me up on Instagram telling me that they came out with a Gen 2 Super Sawzall. And I'm sure they're going to watch this. I don't believe that's what it is, to be honest with you. But anyway, here's some more pictures. So they did a great job, guys. You know, I put a little post up on Instagram. Oh, this is great. Another recip saw. Where's the lawnmower? So, yeah, we just had a you know, Super Sawzall come out 2 years ago. I just want that mower, man. I mean, is it so much to ask? Is it? But they did some upgrades, all right? They redesigned a new REDLINK PLUS Intelligence Electronics, all right? Specifically customized for this tool. Legendary slider crank mechanism and upgrades of a slide crank mechanism that has been a key component for Sawzall recip blade, recip saws for decades, okay? This new saw features a mechanism built with improved dust and water ingress and overall durability, wear and corrosion improvements as well. All right, Milwaukee also upgraded the batteries, the motors, electronics, and the slider crank mechanism. There's also let me see here. They also improved other components, anti-corrosion blade clamp, like I mentioned, a prolonged blade clamp, a blade change lever for fast and easy blade changes has been upgraded to be more wear resistant, and a metal reinforced battery connection for improved durability and battery retention over the life of the tool. All right, guys. So, you know, I think, you know, a lot of people obviously got this new Super Sawzall. When it first came out, obviously it was a pretty popular tool, but a lot of people just waited because it was, you know, one of these new tools that you really needed that 12 amp hour battery, right? I think it came with a 12, if I remember correctly. And it was like $4.99, wasn't it? It was either $3.99 or $4.99. But over time, there was a huge price drop in it. You know, we did a deal, $199, right, for the Super Sawzall, and it came with a free 5 at one point. I don't know if it was during Christmas or if it was quarter one. And a lot of stores started selling the 12-amp-hour kit for like $200. I actually got one for $240 that I did a giveaway with probably a year ago. So I don't know if, you know, the Super Sawzall is a beast, guys. I featured it. I actually have to finish editing the video on it that I started probably a year ago. But it is by far the most powerful Sawzall that I've ever used. Now, with that, you know, power, it's big. It's heavy. It's, you know, that's why you always hear me talk about the Makita, because the Makita offers great power, not as much as the Super Sawzall, but, you know, do you really need it? I mean, listen, if you're running into jobs or material or applications where, you know, the Makita or the DeWalt or the brushless Milwaukee can't handle, right, then get the Super Sawzall. But for an everyday saw, I mean, I would maybe keep the Super Sawzall in the box, you know, bottom of your packout box. And when you need it, it's there. But I think other Sawzalls are just better for more easier jobs, right, than lugging the big Super Sawzall around. I want to check the SPM on the Super Sawzall before I leave, because I know I'm going to get questions on it. And again, this is like leaked, so I don't know all the information about it. I got home from Walmart and running some errands, and my Instagram was packed with pictures and questions. But what the heck? All right, let me see what we got here. It's definitely smaller, it looks. Yeah, it definitely looks smaller. I'm looking at the Super Sawzall. Let me see. Let's take a look and see what we got. I'm sorry, guys, for keeping you. I should pull it up on my phone, to be honest with you, but I didn't want to do that. Okay, let's check. We know 6.8 pounds. No, it is 3,000. And the same 1¼-inch length of stroke. So that's the same. It weighs 8.8 pounds. All right. That's, you know, the big kicker. All right. So 8.8 pounds versus 6.8. I don't think this is with the battery, to be honest with you, because this is with a 12 amp hour battery. All right. So I don't think that the Super Sawzall is lighter. All right. Actually, this is with an 8 amp hour. All right, but just by looking at it, I'm looking at it right here. I don't know, folks. It looks almost identical, except that it's one key. Again, they did do those improvements that I mentioned as well. But they're not calling it a Super Sawzall. I can tell you. See how it says Sawzall right here on the rubber handle here? The Super Sawzall says Super Sawzall. All right. Now, this also does not have orbital action. Again, if you followed me and you heard me talk about it, I think that's a very overrated feature to have. Now, listen, it's awesome to have. It's great to have. But when I hear people commenting saying, the Makita doesn't have orbital action. And then I'm like, do you ever use the orbital action? No, but if I ever need it, it's there. So, you know, take that as it may. But no, it definitely looks a little bit smaller, if you want my honest opinion. And we'll have to see. But it's definitely, I would call this a Gen 2 brushless Sawzall. All right. Again, I could be wrong, but there's no mention of Super Sawzall in the name. It's not written here on the recip like it is on the Gen 1 Super Sawzall. There's no orbital action, so I did get a lot of comments about it saying it was, but hey, if they know something that I don't know, maybe they decided to get rid of the orbital action. But you do have a lot of the same specs, all right? So it would be interesting to know the price point of this. You know, they did make those improvements, right? It is a little bit lighter according to some of the specs. Right? But you are losing that orbital action. And you do get, you know, 21.7. This is really always paired, the Super Sawzall, with 21.700 cells. Here they're, you know, got 2 5 amp hour batteries. But you do have one key. What you would need one key for with a Sawzall, I have no idea. Obviously, it's good for an anti-theft. But they did improve their one key too. They added some things to it, but you know, it's, you know, good in case you know, it does get stolen and stuff like that, but, you know, it says here, customization, store up to 3 custom cut profiles. I mean, I don't know. But anyway, let's get that lawnmower. So the new M18 FUEL SAWZALL. Peace. One key.